Tonight, a very special organist entertains. Sunday evening, the gigantic ballroom of the Tower Blackpool was crammed to overflowing with 4,000 wildly enthusiastic admirers of Reginald Dixon, who was giving his farewell concert. The second half of that memorable and moving occasion was broadcast on Easter Monday. But tonight, we would like you to hear what happened in the first half. So listen now to Reg, opening with a selection of well-known marches.
Thank you.
For those of you who've never visited the tower, let me say that this ballroom is a vast rectangle with two balconies running round three sides and has a high and magnificently ornate ceiling. The white and gold Wurlitzer console rises in the centre of the enormous stage and has been the focal point of Dixon fans for 40 years. Last Sunday evening, the atmosphere was charged with sadness, happiness, and nostalgia, as you'll appreciate when Reg continues now with one of his typical Dixon-type show tune medleys. last Sunday evening at Reg Dixon's farewell concert, Vince Hill was the compere, and here he is announcing our surprise for Reg.
On this very special occasion, it's needless to say that Reg has already had two presentations made to him from the Tower Company right here and, of course, from EMI Records. And, you know, we thought it wouldn't be right for a man who's been broadcasting, well, for nearly 40 years. In fact, his first broadcast was on June the 6th, 1930, to leave without some small token being presented to him by us. And so to mark the occasion and to do that very thing, we have another organist here tonight of not some little repute, I may say. Ladies and gentlemen, the compere of the radio series The Organist Entertains, Mr. Robin Richmond.
Well, I must just explain to you that I sprinted from my seat at the back of the audience and up the stairs to get on the stage, but took the wrong turning and landed in the balcony. The audience were in fits of laughter as I sprinted down, and when I finally made the stage, I was completely out of breath. Listen.
Oh, dear. Well, sit down. Sit down. Well, ladies and gentlemen, may I say, as a fellow organist, today marks the end of an era. And roughly, to paraphrase Arthur Sullivan's Lost Chord, here we are, almost at Reginald Dixon's last chord. And seated this day at the organ, he's certainly neither weary nor ill at ease. And even in retirement, Reg, we hope that your fingers will still sometimes wander over the ivory keys. With your... with your unique personality and artistry, you've delighted not only your millions of fans who do like to be beside the seaside, but also your millions of radio fans all over the world. So on behalf of the BBC and our special program, The Organist Entertains, I have great personal pleasure and honor in presenting you with this symbolic replica of your famous Tower Ballroom Wurlitzer.
Really kind of you, really kind.
As a lasting mark of our gratitude for all the happiness you've given and of the affection we all feel and will always feel for the one and only Reginald Dixon.
And so now we go to a theme from a film called While I Live. Many of you won't remember the film, but I know that the theme is very much in your minds, as quite a number of you have asked for it. It's The Dream of Alwyn.
Well, at this moment, the audience were delighted when Reg brought on stage his successor at the Mighty Tower. Well, it's Ernest Broadbent.
Well, Ernest, as you know, the show isn't over tonight, but I thought at this stage, I know you've got probably other work to do for them in the meantime, but I'd like to wish you a very happy and successful time in Blackpool, very sincerely. All the best to you, and carry on the good work.
And thank you, Reg, and I wish you a very happy retirement. I know you're going to play a lot, but still, have a good time.
Thank you very much.
The first half of this memorable, even historic, farewell concert ended with a medley of popular tunes played in the unique and typical Dixon style, in which, even in retirement, he displayed all the sparkle and musical athletics which have made him a legend in his own lifetime. And so we end our recording of part of Reginald Dixon's farewell concert. Sad we are indeed to say goodbye to Mr. Blackpool. But all is not lost, because through the medium of radio and records, I can assure you that we should be hearing more from the one and only Reginald Dixon.
Now, just before we go on with our programme, a slippery road warning from our motoring unit. Snow showers are likely to cause slippery roads in the north of England, East Midlands, East Anglia and the South East this evening. Motorists are advised to use extra care. That some roads in the north, Midlands, South East and East Anglia, which may become slippery this evening. Your programme is Radio 2 on 1500 metres, 247 metres and VHF.